ora pro nobis peccatoribus nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Stay back!
Remain calm, Monseigneur. You are safe now.
What did they do to me? This dream. This nightmare.
What nightmare, Monseigneur?
It was terrible. I was but a shadow among shadows. There was so much anger, despair. How long has it been? A day? A year? Oh, fire! There were flames everywhere! And death! The suffering I was forced to inflict! Oh, Lord, what have I done? Is this the hell that awaits our immortal souls once our time on this earth has ended? If this is true, then how are we to go on living with nothing to hope for, nothing to believe in?
How were you captured, Monseigneur?
I was with Abbé Grégoire in Place Dauphine. We'd gone to speak with the volunteers of the Garde Nationale. We implored them not to take up arms against the king's machines. Alas, they refused to heed our words, and we had to leave in great haste. After that, mon Dieu, I can't remember a thing. Those poor people. These automats were truly made in the mold of their master. Ruthless! To think, for just one simple reproach against the court, the king cast me into hell.
You owe your freedom to Abbé Grégoire.
The good abbot, I tell you, this man is utterly irreplaceable. He has devoted himself body and soul to the mission I entrusted to him. Investigating the king's entourage, in particular the man who enabled him to create this ungodly army. But, mon Dieu, the notes!
What notes, Monseigneur?
The notes the abbot placed in my safekeeping. Those heretics took them.
I know where the documents can be found. I must go to the Châtelet prison.
What shall I do? Where will I be safe?
Go and join the abbot at the Société des Amis des Noirs. The way is clear for now, but you must go quickly. More automats will be here soon. The Châtelet prison is at the other end of the Pont en Change. This grappling hook will be very useful.
Thank you. Come to me, my dear. You're not like the others, are you? You gave them quite a beating.
Madame.
Why didn't you come sooner, ma chère? Those poor children in the National Guard. They could have used your help. They marched all day on the Pont Neuf. Oh, you should have heard them singing as they marched on the Place Dauphine. They were very brave then. To hear them, you'd think that the king had already handed over his crown.
Then what happened?
As far as I know, gunfire, the booming of cannons, shouting, lots of shouting. And then, silence.
None of the soldiers returned?
No, not a single one. My son, my little Francois, he left this morning to join the volunteers, but he hasn't given any sign of life since.
I'll try to find out what happened to him. Madame.
Do you have any news of my son?
No, Madame.
Will I never see him again in this lifetime?
We've got to get out of here quickly. We're in grave danger. These machines have neither heart nor mind. No mercy can be expected from them.
And where do you hope to find refuge, mon cher voisin? The enemy is everywhere, and they take no prisoners.
Thank you. Je sois loué. It is such a blessing to see you safe and sound.
This belongs to you.
Bless you, whoever you are. You have our eternal gratitude.
I believe you've met Monsieur Julien Raymond from distant Saint-Domingue. He's one of the most eminent members of our organization.
And you, Mademoiselle? What should we call you?
My name is Aegis.
Ah, yes. The Aegis. The mighty shield and scourge of Zeus.
I wonder. Earlier, by the Pont Neuf, when you touched Monseigneur's ring, can you explain what happened?
The ring called to me. It compelled me to reach out and take it.
Come now.
The moment I touched it, I was transported. Somewhere else. It was the same strange world that you were in, Monseigneur.
Hell, you mean?
Or purgatory.
I saw things there. I saw Monseigneur giving a sermon.
What wickedness is this?
This explains the moment when you froze. And this isn't the only time you've experienced something like this, n'est-ce pas?
That is correct. It also happened with two objects I found in Place Dauphine.
And what happened there?
That is where I found your Bible and your cross, Monseigneur.
How did you know they belonged to me?
They demanded to be returned to you. You did not regain consciousness until I did so.
This is madness!
Let us not be so quick to judge, Monseigneur.
I witnessed the moment when your cross was taken from you. Then I saw you being locked in that box.
Et bien voilà. It is just as I suspected. Here, Aegis, look at this. Over the course of my research, I unearthed this ancient document. I believe I have finally uncovered its meaning. It's a triangle with an identical inscription at each corner. Nemi, memory in ancient Greek. Then in the center, there is an open eye which symbolizes awakening. Do you understand? The images you saw, Aegis, were Monseigneur de la Fare's own memories. Three echoes of the past tied to personal objects of his. Three Nemi's memories which some dark alchemy had taken from him. Without them, his mind would have remained lost, incomplete. He would never have regained consciousness. But by returning these three objects to him, Aegis, you were able to save his immortal soul.
Tell me, Aegis, when you were at the clerk's office at the Châtelet, did you perhaps see a leather wallet near the abbot's documents?
No, Monseigneur.
Ah, that is unfortunate. Most unfortunate.
Mon père.
Plus tard, s'il vous plaît. I need a moment alone. I must read over my notes in light of what we have just discovered.
Monseigneur? That other world where you were held prisoner. Do you still feel its effects?
This other world, as you call it, Aegis, is none other than hell itself, Gehenna. The place the Lord sends those who worship the beast. But hell didn't keep me. Has God given me a chance to redeem myself, perhaps?
What task did you entrust to the abbot?
The Holy Office ordered me to keep an eye on the Comte de Cagliostro. This charlatan imagines himself to be the heir of Mesmer, the magnetizer, and seems to have ingratiated himself with the king. There have been disturbing reports about him that could lead to his excommunication. It is said that he can make the dead speak. Can you imagine? I asked the abbot to investigate the surroundings of Eugène de Vaucanson's workshop, where the count had been seen coming and going for several weeks. I cannot disclose the details of what he discovered there, but it may well be related to the events that have plunged Paris into mourning.
I bid you farewell, Monseigneur.
Wait just a moment, s'il vous plaît. You are one of Cagliostro's creatures, are you not?
What do you mean?
When did you awaken?
I do not understand, Monseigneur.
Well, that is to say, you talk, you think, you seem to act with some sort of free will. This was not always the case, that much is clear. You must agree that not all automates are as sophisticated as yourself. I'm attempting to unravel the mystery of your true nature. Tell me, what are your very first memories?
That is a question I am unable to answer.
How strange. In that case, you must surely be able to tell me who taught you what you know.
What I know, Monseigneur?
How can I put it in a way that you'll understand? For example, you call me Monseigneur. How do you know that this is how one addresses a member of the clergy of my rank?
I cannot explain it. I believe...
Go on, Aegis.
I believe that this knowledge is not mine.
Well, I never. Did you hear that, Abbot?
I caught every word, mon ami.
Monsieur Raymond, what is the aim of this organization?
We publish articles and exert our influence on those who are in a position to improve the lot of our unfortunate brethren. Our numbers grow by the day, and we have many illustrious members, such as the Comte de Mirabeau and the Marquis de Lafayette. But it was Monsieur Brissot and the Abbot that founded the group.
Good old Brissot. Shouldn't he be here by now?
Yes, mon père. He should have arrived hours ago. Alas, there has been no sign of him.
I hope to God that no misfortune has befallen him.
What fate does the kingdom reserve for those with black skin?
According to tradition, any enslaved person who sets foot on French soil is freed.
This rule is most problematic in the eyes of planters in the colonies, who would seek to maintain their precious labor force.
This is why, for the past 12 years, no black people have been allowed to disembark in any of the kingdom's ports. Those who accompany their masters on the journey are imprisoned in the Admiralty's jails the moment they leave the ship. As for those who manage to evade the authorities, they live in fear of the raids carried out by the Marshalsea.
Are you not subject to these laws, Monsieur Raymond?
I am fortunate enough to have been born a subject of the king through my father, and also to have received an education. And to be wealthy.
Naturally, that makes all the difference.
You are quite a long way from home, Monsieur Raymond.
I haven't been back to Saint-Domingue in nearly 5 years. I left my most trusted men in charge of overseeing my indigo plantation. I came to France with the aim of having an audience with the king. I hoped to convince him to use his automats for agricultural work. I was of the belief that this was the best way to ease the suffering of our enslaved brethren. Alas, it was all for naught. I was only able to get an audience with the Minister of the Navy, and even that was granted reluctantly. Later, when the King convened the Estates General, my hopes were renewed. I saw it as an opportunity to make our voices heard. And then, mon Dieu, what a disaster, Aegis. What a complete disaster.
Thank you.
Monsieur de Mirabeau's home is built on a hill in the area.
Look at me. You have to hang in there, all right? You mustn't fall asleep.
Is there any way I can help you?
Send you an automat.
What can I expect from you, other than the cruel fate that your fellow monsters reserve for patriots?
You have nothing to fear from me, monsieur.
Honestly, I don't have much of a choice. I have to take you at your word and ask for your help. I have with me a fighter who has lost his leg. He's already lost a lot of blood. If I don't operate within the hour, I doubt he will survive. Unfortunately, I do not have any surgical tools with me. Would you be so kind as to find me something I can use to save this brave man? I can't do anything until I have the right equipment.
Thank you.
So, I put it to you that the fact that the society is in need of
Monsieur de Mirabeau.
The demon can speak? Speak then! Has my time come?
I do not know.
My life is in your hands. It's not worth much. Do what you will with it.
I seek Monsieur de Vaucanson. He holds the secret to the tireless automats.
And you think you'll find him here, in my quarters? Tell me, who is your master? Aren't you one of Cagliostro's creatures?
I serve only the Queen.
Ah, the Queen. Well then, that's something else altogether.
I found this message in Monsieur de Vaucanson's carriage.
He didn't receive it. That is most worrying. Eugène and I are old friends. I was hoping he would be able to tell me what the deuce is going on. Of course, I doubt he had a hand in this odious display of force, but he spent years in service to the king and his projects. Projects whose macabre ends we're only now discovering.
Where could Monsieur de Vaucanson have gone?
How should I know? The situation is dire out there. Everyone is taking shelter wherever they can. Let me think. I know that he and Monsieur Bailly, the astronomer, are close. Perhaps Monsieur Bailly knows more?
Where can he be found?
He must have taken refuge in his observatory at the Louvre. Otherwise, I doubt he is still alive. He and his associate Lavoisier, the astronomer and the chemist, they were once the pride of the court, but have fallen out of favor. Too close to the common people, it would seem. It's as if only Vaucanson managed to stay in the king's good graces. Sic transit gloria mundi.
Who is this Cagliostro?
You feign ignorance.
I do not know.
Then you should know that Cagliostro is the king's right-hand man. He claims to be a magician, and he is a self-styled count.
A charlatan who is more powerful than a minister.
Precisely. I've heard the most troubling rumors about him. He's supposedly the one who enabled the king to breathe life into these killing machines that no key need wind. I admit it sounds highly improbable, and I wouldn't believe a word of it if I didn't have proof standing right before my eyes. Now that I think about it, as you can see, my servants have all abandoned me, and I will soon follow their lead. Those poor people hoped to escape the city while there was still time. A dire vrai, I fear I shall never see them alive again. Before she left, the housekeeper gave me this key. It opens the gate that leads to the Louvre, if you are foolhardy enough to attempt it.
I found a note written by Eugène de Vaucanson. He mentions the death of the Dauphin at Meudon. What happened that night?
How should I know? The child passed away at Meudon. I was in Versailles.
Besides the king and Monsieur de Vaucanson, who else witnessed these events?
Well, if they followed protocol, Monsieur Le Monnier, the first physician to the king, he must have performed the autopsy on the child.
Where can I find him?
He lives in Versailles, near the chateau. But he has a practice here in Paris, on Rue Saint-Thomas d'Enfer, in the Quartier Saint-André-des-Arts.
Eugène de Vaucanson told you nothing?
The only thing he was willing to tell me was that something terrible had happened, and that the circumstances leading to the Dauphin's death were not exactly as described. One thing for certain is that he was extremely upset about what happened, so much so that he refused to spend a single day more in the king's service. But he has apparently changed his mind.
saw Richard today as clearly as I can see you now.
It's impossible. That makes no sense.
Do you think I've gone mad?
No, of course not. But how could Monsieur Balsamo make these machines obey him?
Monsieur Balsamo, you say?
De Jesu! An automat right on our doorstep!
Malheur! We are lost!
Do not fear. I am not like the other machines.
A la bonne heure. This one speaks and thinks, at least.
We'd better stay on our guard.
So you saw this Monsieur Balsamo giving orders to the machines?
Bien sûr. I saw him walk through the gate to his workshop, just a few paces from here, accompanied by a dozen automats. They made no move to attack him. Oh no, bien au contraire, they were acting like his bodyguards.
What does Monsieur Balsamo do?
Who knows? He's a very discreet man.
Discreet? You'd have to be deaf to find him discreet. What about the racket keeps us up every night? The clatter of scrap metal, the creaking of pulleys, rumblings of all kinds. We suffer through it all. Not to mention the god-awful screams that emanate from that sinister workshop from time to time.
A most unusual fanfare, c'est vrai. However, there's no way of knowing what he's doing there. And that's why we cannot tell you anything more.
Madame, would you be so kind as to leave now? We don't want to draw attention to ourselves.